There's a bright and shining city where the roses are in bloom. There's a mansion being built for me. When I close my earthly story and they've laid me in the tomb, I'll become a millionaire, oh, can't you see? Have you talked with my Redeemer? Is your robe as white as snow? Do you have a blessing that has set you free? This blessing, there is something you should know, brother. You can be a millionaire with me. Don't you want to share my riches? Streets of gold, don't you wanna meet me over there? He will make you join in glory, keep you happy all the way, and he'll give to you a mansion in the end. Have you talked with my Redeemer? Is your robe as white as snow? Do you have a blessing that has set you free? If you've never had this blessing, there is something you should know, brother. You can be a millionaire with me. That has set you free. If you've never had this blessing, there is something you should know, brother. You can be a millionaire with me. Brother, you can be a millionaire with me.
Good morning. All right. Who didn't get wet this morning? Ooh, that's nice. All right. I hope you got a bulletin. We got a lot going on. This month is about at the tail end. If you're interested in being a member, if you'll see me after the service. Also, the 2x2, they will meet tonight at 5 o'clock. They're going to meet over in Arena 2, and they're having a Nerf War night. And bring your own Nerf gun and the goggles. Bullets will be provided. $5 a person. Also, the recycled teenagers, they will meet at 5 o'clock. They're having potluck. Wednesday, ages 7 to 11, 12 to 19, and 20 and up. We're in 1 Samuel 26. We all three groups get to meet in separate places. It's kind of a family deal. Also, Thursday is Cowboy Rescue. This week is Mexican. And the meal's at 6 and the service is at 7. If anybody ever feels led to give their testimony or speak, give us a holler. We'd sure love to have you. Today, the 24th, we're having a calendar meeting at 4:30. So all the team leaders, you need to have your team reports in, and you need to be here or be represented, because we go through finding out what team, if you may need something, or you need to be here to get your event or your meeting on the calendar. And that's at 4:30. At 4 o'clock, we're having a greeting team meeting. And if you're interested in being on the greeting team, and that's not just here at the church, but it's also different events we have where we have people coming in. You know, they say the first 15 minutes of a person's first visit usually determines if they're going to come back or not. Now, if you go up somebody's head pretty quick, you may not want to be on the greeting team. But also, the revival camp meeting with Ray Perryman, that's October the 8th through the 11th. That's here at the church. Ray Perryman is the one that does our rodeo Bible camp. And this is where our zone gets together and has an old-timey camp meeting. We're going to be meeting right here at the church. And that's the 8th through the 11th. I know they're probably going to have a list up for food and snacks and things. Thursday is FCA Fields of Faith, and that's at Cabot School. And if you ordered a T-shirt, Brother Preston said they're here. You need to pick up your T-shirts. I don't see. The 25th, Monday, is dummy team roping. 6 to 8 in Arena 2. If you're interested, contact Steve Westbrook or Preston McCord. Everyone is invited. Next Sunday, there won't be any services on Sunday night because we're having the awards banquet for the ATRA. And then the last Saturday of October, we start the ATRA season back up. So if you're interested, up to 19 years, we'd sure love to have you. Arkansas Teenage Rodeo Association. Am I missing anything? All right, let's go to the Lord. This morning, Father, we thank you for each and every blessing you bestow upon us. Thank you for your goodness and your grace. Thank you for this rain, Father, that we so desperately needed. Thank you for the cool weather. And we just pray this morning, Father, as we come to worship you and to lift up your holy name. As always, we take this opportunity to invite your spirit to be in our midst and to have your way. We pray that you would move and minister, touch every heart in whatever way is needed. We give you full reign, full control. This morning, we pray that you continue to bless and anoint the song service, the message, as well as the message bearer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
There is coming a day where no heartache shall come, no more clouds in the sky, no more tears to dim the eye. All is peace forevermore on that happy golden shore. What a day, glorious day.
Happy to be in the house of the Lord this morning. Give him some praise this morning. Amen. 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 Well, we're glad to have you here this morning. My name is Preston McCord. I'm the youth pastor here this morning. But we want to welcome you here to CrossRoads Cowboy Church. I think most of you know how this works, but for those that are new here this morning, well, you've probably seen the arena as you came in the chapel this morning. But we have an arena out here. That's our mission field. That's where we put on events or have events that's held here. And we come in and try to get to know everybody that comes through these gates, through enters these arenas or enters these stands. And we try to get to know them. We invite them to church. And when they come in here, that's when we hope that they grow to know the Lord more. And most of you that are here, that are members, you know exactly what we're about, and that's probably what brought you here this morning. But we are glad to have you here this morning. I'm excited to be here again with you this morning. Of course, you probably can tell that Brother Ron and Miss Wanda are not here this morning. Well, they're dearly missed. I know you're probably missing Miss Wanda's hugs and smiles this morning, but I want you to know that they are down at MD Anderson. She went down there some more tests. So one thing I want to add to our prayer list is of course travel, but pray for Miss Wanda for those tests. They're believing, they're hoping, and they're proclaiming that she has no cancer, and we would ask you to continue to pray for that. And know that God is in control, and that there is no cancer, and she'll come back with that report this week. But with that being said, we'll have our young people start up. We're going to pass the hat here in just a few moments. But I do not have the list. I don't know what happened to our prayer list we usually have up here, but we're going to be all right. We know that there's several of you that have been on your knees hard for each one that we've had on our prayer list for quite some time. I know we've had some on there that's been on there for, like I said, quite some time, but we know that there's a few. And I know that each one of you have somebody in your heart this morning that you've probably been praying about or thinking about this morning. So we are going to do something just a little bit different. As I said, we need a few more. We need three more young people, if you don't care, to have them come up this way so we can have two on each side here to pass the hat. And but this morning, I just kind of felt God telling us to do something just a little bit different. Can I get two of you on this side? Two of you young people, can I get one on this side and one on the other side there? You can stay over here, young man. Young man, you want to stay right here? Can I get you to come right here? Right there. There you go. Perfect. Good job. So this morning, I want to encourage you to uncover. We're going to go to the Lord in prayer this morning. And first off, like I said, I know there's several of them that was on the list, Lord, and I know that you have, each one of you here know of at least one, if not more, that was on that list. But right now in your hearts, I just want to encourage you to just speak to God right now, Lord. Just lift that person or them people up right now in your heart, in your prayers, in your heart right now. And maybe you feel God that's saying that you need to express this name out loud, to lay it at the foot of the cross. I want to encourage you to do that right now. Lift that name up right now to him, right now. That's right, amen. Lord, they're all over the room this morning, Lord. Right now they're being laid right there at the foot of the cross where they belong. And Lord, I'm going to pray right now for these people in this room this morning. Lord, so overwhelming to hear all the names in this room. Lord, they know that prayer list, Lord. They know the needs that are out there this morning. Lord, we're so thankful for you. We know that you're an all-knowing God and all-loving God. And as those names are entering the throne room this morning, at the foot of the cross where they belong, Lord, we give them to you, Lord. They're in better hands than they could ever imagine, from the best doctor or whatever need it be. They're at the best hands right now, Lord. Lord, we're so thankful for you this morning, Lord. We just pray for each of those needs, Lord. We know we have several on that cancer list. We have several that maybe just be hurts or heartaches. And each one, Lord, is important to you, Lord. We're so thankful that we can bring each need, each situation, Lord, to you this morning. And we know that you care for us and love us. Father, this morning we pray right now, Lord. We pray for your message. And Lord, we just pray right now, Lord, that each person that's here, we know that it's not an accident. We know that you have sent them here this morning for your word. And Lord, that's what I pray this morning. It's not going to be my words, it'll be your words. And I want to challenge each person here this morning. I'd ask for each one of them, if they want to say it out loud or in their heart or however, but I'd ask them to say this phrase this morning. I trust you. Amen. Father God, we do trust you this morning, Lord. We know that you have something very, very special for each person. And I know we know that you're going to move and minister in a mighty way this morning. Father God, we pray for this offering that you're about to receive, Lord. It's all yours anyways, but Lord, we bring a tenth, a tithe to you this morning. Lord, we just pray that it will go and it will further the kingdom, Lord, that you'll use it in mighty ways to not only further your kingdom, but Lord, that for each person that is in need, Lord, that they know that it came from you. Father God, we love you this morning, and we're so gracious and thankful for the name above every name, your Son, Jesus Christ, and we pray it all in your name. Amen. If you'll pass the hat, and the band will come back and play us a song.
Well, started out traveling for the Lord many years ago. Well, I had a lot of heartache, I had a lot of beef and woe. Well, when I would stumble, then I would humble down. And there I'd say I would take nothing for my journey now. Well, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Gotta make the head somehow. Though the devil tempts me and tried to turn me around, but he's offered everything that's got a name on the world. I want the world is pain. If I could tell, I would take nothing for my journey now. In the world that could ever take the place of God's love. Well, silver and gold never by touch from above. Whoa. Well, soul needs a healing. I begin to feel in his power. Then I can say, praise the Lord, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Well, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Gotta make it to heaven somehow. Though the devil tempted and tried to turn me around, he's offered everything that's got a name. All the wealth I want, a world of fame. If I could still, I would take up for my journey now. Thank you.
take nothing for my journey now.
It's time for Kids Corral. Everybody 3 to 11 years old going upstairs. Kids Corral on Sunday morning. Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world. Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in His sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world. This morning I am thankful, grateful. I'm thankful for this band, all three of us. Now, Miss Wanda has been battling some respiratory illness for several weeks. Keep her in your prayers because she's struggling, and it is weighing on her because you know how much she loves this place and loves this man and loves to worship with you, and so hold her up. Nathan, he's a diabetic, had some problems this morning, so keep him in your prayers. We got a couple of folks traveling, so we didn't break up. We just, there's things going on. And Larry had eye surgery. If you saw him with his sunglasses on, it looked like we were doing a ZZ Top tribute band. But to say that I'm thankful and grateful is an understatement. The enemy can come against you and get you down and whisper things in your ear and just make you think that it ain't ever going to get all right. But in that, somehow this morning I was reminded of, I've told this story before, but when I was a little kid, little bitty, my legs didn't work. You pick me up under the arms of my feet and my legs turn around backward. And they took me to every kind of clinic that you could have and every kind of doctor and all over the place. And they said, well, here's what it's going to be. You're going to have a disabled child, and he's going to grow up that way, and so you might as well get ready for it. So I had the braces on the legs and the whole thing. And my mama, God rest her soul, said, I just ain't having it because I believe there's a God in heaven that wants it different. So she started praying, and she went to church, and she prayed, and she gathered the whole church just kind of like around here. And everybody gathered up and prayed. And lo and behold, God healed me 100%. No braces, no disabled. In everything I've done since then, across the United States and around the world, up and down and living for God and not, He's never left me, not one time. Even if I left Him, He was always right where I left Him when I came back. He's faithful. The Bible says, as a deer panteth after the water brook, so panteth my soul after Thee, O God. It's kind of in my heart this morning. His grace is amazing, and it never gets old. Worship with us.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like the hour.
believe. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me.
This morning, I'm very thankful for our band. You know, to come up here and let God shine through each one of them, the gifts and the callings and the talents that God has laid on their life, with missing so many in the band, and they outpoured what God has gifted them like they did this morning. We got to give God some praise this morning. Definitely thankful. You know, I'm also thankful for this church. You know, I tell a lot of people about this church, but I usually just try to tell them to come. Already in this service this morning, it's evident that the Spirit is in this church this morning. And it's so good to have the Spirit. And just like the songs they were singing this morning, we're so thankful for God's grace and how good He is to us. And I know y'all are too this morning. This morning, I want to talk to you about trust again. I know last time we were here together, I preached on trust, and we talked about David and how he ran from Saul for 7 years, if you remember, and but he continually to seek the Lord. We're going to go at it a little bit different angle this morning. This morning, we're going to be in John 5. If you want to turn over your Bibles, I'm going to encourage you to do that. But today we're going to be in John 5, and we're going to talk about a man. He didn't run from anything for a long period of time, but he was stuck in a place still where didn't have a way to go anywhere for even longer time. But we're going to see how he indeed had to also trust God this morning. I hope that y'all, when we prayed this morning, and I encourage you to say, I trust you, Lord, that you did that this morning. And I pray that this morning that the word that God has laid on my heart will touch you in a way that you'll trust him, even if you have the trust more than anyone in this room, that you'll increase your trust when you walk out here today. So, the point of the matter is, I wanted to, whatever you may be going through in life, I know that most of us were always, or hopefully we're always seeking the Lord, but you know, it's human nature for us to try to help God along, isn't it? Try to help him in his process. Anybody been guilty of that before? Amen. Exactly, I have too. Well, like I said, today we're going to talk about a man that was stuck in one spot. He tried everything he could, but he got to a point where he became still stuck in a place with the same issue, with hope fading away, desperate and at the end of his rope for 38 years. If you'll turn to your Bibles, John chapter 1, we're going to read the first 9 verses of this chapter. And it says in verse 1, after this, there was a feast for the Jews. And Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is in Jerusalem by the sheep gate a pool which is called in Hebrew Bethesda, having 5 porches. In this lay a great multitude of sick people, blind, lame, paralyzed, waiting for the moving of the water. For an angel went down at a certain time into the pool and stirred up the water. Then whoever stepped in first, after the stirring of the water, was made well of whatever disease that he had. Now a certain man was there who had an infirmity for 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there, he knew that he had already been there in that condition for a long time. And he said to him, "Do you want to be made well?" The sick man answered him, "Sir, I have no man to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up, but while I am coming, another steps down before me." Jesus said to him, "Rise, take up your bed, and walk." And immediately the man was made well, took up his bed, and he walked. Let's pray. Father, we come to you this morning, Lord God. And each person here probably has something that they need to be made well from. It may be something that's life-threatening, or maybe something that's just a small issue with everyday life. But Father God, allow us to trust you here this morning through your words, through your word here in John. Allow us to take up our beds and walk. We pray it in your name, Jesus' name. Amen. So John paints this picture. We see that this man, he had some kind of problem for 38 years. The man was paralyzed. He was lying beside the pool of Bethesda. The Bible tells us that an angel would come down to this pool at a certain time, and he would begin to stir the water. Now, whoever entered the pool after the stirring of the water would be made well. Then we see Jesus entering the picture. We see that he sees the man lying there, and he knows that he's already been in this condition for a long time. Jesus asks the man, "Do you want to be made well?" You know, it's interesting, because we know that Jesus knows everything about us, right? He knows what you're going through. He knows what you have in your hearts. And he might be asking you today if you want to be made well. You know, at first, as I was putting this together, I thought, you know, that just seems like an odd question. An odd question for, because probably everybody knew about this pool in Bethesda, right? We probably think that, you know, everyone for miles and miles around knew about the pool. And each person that would gather and stay by the pool, they were needing to be made well. You know, that'd be like something going on around here, like something like that. I mean, everybody would know. I know it's different days now, but I mean, it'd be all over the globe. Everybody would know about it. But I bet you it had such a big impact that surely there was no one that didn't know about the pool of Bethesda. But as I began to think about this, I began to think about what this man probably thought in his mind about the question that Jesus had for him. You know, I began to think about, you know, this man probably thinks, who in the world is this man? You know, where does he came from that he was in a place that he didn't know about this pool, about what this does? Why would he ask me this? He sees me lying here. He sees all these others lying around, waiting on the pool, the stirring of the pool. And he probably knows that I'm trying to do my best to enter this pool. You know, I bet he said, I can't believe that he even have the nerve to ask me this. Surely he knows about this. Why would he even ask me this question? And then I thought, maybe this man thinks, he doesn't know who Jesus is, but he says to himself, this man has no idea what I've been through for 38 years. He doesn't know the half of my story. But the man, the sick man, he answers him, sir, I have no man to put me into this water when the water is stirred up. But while I'm coming, another steps down before me. We're a lot like that, aren't we? Excuses. He had an excuse. The sick man has been telling him excuses, his self-excuses, been telling himself bad stories for a very long time. For 38 years, nobody, he tells himself, nobody wants to help me. Everyone is always out against me. Every time I try to enter, there's someone that jumps in front of me and gets down there first. Every one of these people do not care about me. The sick man thinks, Jesus has no idea what I've been through. The sick man has no idea who Jesus is. Now, see, this is the beginning of Jesus' miracles. This is before he started his miracles. But the sick man thinks that this man, Jesus, hasn't even heard the half of his story. So we see that this sick man is skeptical. He's doubtful. He's unfamiliar with the man named Jesus. This sick man has lost all hope. And all he understands anymore, or thinks anymore, is that he is stuck in a broken system. He feels stuck. He feels stuck in a broken system, and I believe that some of us here today probably feel the same way. The sick man, he felt like he was stuck in a broken story. And I feel that some of us, if we would be honest, maybe we feel like we're in a similar story this morning. And maybe this sick man began to think at some point in his life that maybe he deserved to suffer, deserved what he was going through. But I want you to understand that that was a lie, and it's a lie if you're thinking that here today, because it comes from the pit of hell, from the biggest liar of them all. His name is Satan, and John 10:10 tells us that he comes to steal, and he comes to destroy. But Jesus came to give not only him, but us an abundant life. Amen? That's right. Jesus came to show us it's not about religion, but it's about a relationship. That's right. But this sick man, he doesn't understand this yet. He doesn't know who Jesus is. All he understands is that no one wants to help him. He knows that he's been trying. And he's probably in a place that he thinks, if these other people would just understand how hard that I have been trying to enter this pool and know how hard I've been trying to get well. And all this was true right before Jesus showed up. It was true for a long time, but his situation has changed as Jesus entered the picture. Grace has shown up. Grace is here now. And what used to be true isn't true anymore. Are you stuck in something that used to be true but isn't true anymore? You know, I bet this man, he was trying, being in this situation for 38 years, trying to take care of himself, but no one cared. Just another cripple by the pool is probably what he thought. And that's easy to understand before you understand grace, isn't it? It's easy to be in a state of mind before we understand who Jesus is and what he can provide, isn't it right? Amen. Some of us mess up our thinking by living in the past, thinking that no one can help us. But there Jesus stood in front of the sick man. He was saying, I can help. Jesus can help you here this morning. But the real question this morning is, how did Jesus command this sick man to get up? The sick man that couldn't move, couldn't get into the pool before Jesus entered the picture. He was unable to walk before Jesus showed up. You know, one interpretation of the text says that his reward was in obedience. But I don't believe that. I believe that's religion. Because the fact of the matter is that if trying harder was good enough, that this man would have been made well a long, long time ago. That's like a lot of us here today. If trying harder was good enough, then our stories would be different by now. If trying harder would have worked, a lot of us would read our Bibles more often. We would be able to make it to church on time or more often. Or we would be living more in God's will. And if trying would have worked, it would have worked by now for you as well. But the sick man said, I've been trying. I've been trying to get in this pool, and you have no idea how it feels to see each one of these others be made well, and I'm stuck behind. You have no idea how it feels to be made fun of like I have. You have no idea what I've been through. You have no idea what my life has been like. You have no idea what my dad was like, what my mom put me through. You have no idea. I've been trying to have a better life. I've been trying to provide better for my wife, for my husband, for my kids. I've been trying. The sick man was trying, and I believe Jesus was telling him to try too. I think Jesus was saying, I knew you couldn't reach the water, so I'm bringing the living water to you. Amen? So the sick man said, I'm trying, and Jesus said, try, trust. Get up, take up your bed, and walk. And he said, I'm trying, and Jesus said, trust me. He said, I'm trying. Jesus was saying, trust me. Isn't that the real task, to trust God and his will and his timing? What makes Maybe it's what a combination of works and grace that makes up trust. I don't know, but I know that there are some of you here today that you've been trying your best, but we need to try to trust Jesus. And then your story will be different. You'll be able to have a different story. You'll break the system. Jesus understands, just like he understood the sick man that he was trying, he knows that you have been trying as well. But Jesus is telling us today, will you try to trust me? This is a trust moment. This is a trust decision. Whatever you may be going through this morning. Just like the sick man, as he trusted Jesus and made well, we too can trust in Jesus. We can be healed from whatever it is that we have going on today. And that we can take up our bed and we can walk in the promises that only Him, only He, only Jesus can provide. I want to encourage you here this morning. Just as Jesus commanded the sick man to get up, to think about how he looks in the eyes of Jesus this morning. And as he tells him to get up and take up his bed and walk, he's here this morning and he's telling you to take up your bed, whatever it is you have going on this morning, and walk and know that you can trust in the one true Savior, Jesus Christ, this morning. If you'll uncover, let's go to prayer this morning. Father, I wonder if there's someone here today, Lord, that's in that place, Lord, that they need to trust you. They're going through something, Lord, that's got them stuck where they can't get up. It's something that has got them held down in a position that they don't know what to do. They've tried everything that they can think of. They're trying here this morning. Lord, help them to understand to try trust. I wonder if you're here today and you say, I've been going through something that's got me knocked down, but I'm here today. I'm going to hand it over and trust in the Lord this morning. Would you slip up your hand? They're all over the room, Lord, this morning. I encourage you right now to lay it at the foot of the cross this morning. Give it to God right now. Have that conversation with Him right now that you're going to trust Him. You're going to hand it over and know that as the result will be that you will take up your bed and you'll walk through what you're going through right now. I pray that you start trusting God in a relationship every day through His Son, Jesus Christ. If you're here this morning and you're not sure that you ever asked Jesus to come into your heart, well, today is the day of salvation. You can come today and put your full trust in the one that came to save the world. If you're here this morning and you want to ask Jesus to come in your heart, slip up your hand. We encourage you by admitting your sin and want to turn from it, like we talk about the ABCs all the time. Believing in Jesus, believing that God raised Him from the dead and He can raise you from what you're going through this morning. And to confess Him. We confess Him just like I ask you to raise your hand. We confess Him by the way we live and the way we talk. Let Jesus shine in through us. We also confess Him by baptism. Father, I pray, Lord, for each person here this morning, Lord God. There may be a small or big issue, Lord, but I pray, Lord, that there's decisions being made, Lord, that they're going to trust you more this morning. Father, help us to go out into the world, Lord, as we leave and depart from this place this morning. I pray, Lord, that we can trust you in every area, every thought, everything that we have. And, Lord, that others can see Jesus through the way we live our lives. Lord, we love you and we thank you so much for Jesus and dying on the cross for our sins. And we pray this above in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I encourage you to go out there and tell someone else about Jesus Christ and tell them about Crossroads Cowboy Church. Hope you have a great day.